Like I told you, and my apologies if I did not. I mean, I'm talking to three different batches of people, which is the admissions officer has one customer who they want to impress. That is the professors. And they are very concerned about two things. One is what's called as the yield rate, which is how many people who they made an offer to accepted or rejected. Okay, yield rate is typically how many left the school, did not make it to that school or went somewhere else. Even Stanford doesn't have 100%. Okay, even those schools have like 70-80% yield rates. So yield rates are a very big concern for schools, particularly the smaller schools which are not as good, or at least they're like that, not outside the top 50. Yield rate is a huge problem because A, they have to report it, okay, and they don't like reporting such stuff. That's right. Should be on the call there. So that was my little one kind of trying to interrupt in between. She didn't realize we were on a session. But the yield rate is super important to realize. And then second thing is the professors, right? The professors are the customers of these admissions officers. So the professors don't like the cohort that has come in, which they don't think they're as excited about their particular subject. They yell at those admissions officers. So remember those two customers, I will come back to that. But yield rate is very important to understand that, you know, they want to make sure that you're really going to come there. So you have to give those buying signals that, hey, if you make me the offer, I will come to you. It's like proposing to somebody. You only propose when you know the odds of getting a yes are pretty high. And that's something which I didn't do a good job of learning. So I got turned on a lot of times, but that's a different problem. But most people are pretty good about that.
We have some more questions.
Yes.
So Jessica asked, do your rec letters have to be from teachers at school? And do they require this? And then if so, does it have to be one STEM teacher and one humanities, or does it not really matter? And is it better to have a junior year teacher who does not know you as well, or a sophomore year that you had for 2 years? Have sophomore year teacher that you had for 2 years.
Why don't you go ahead, Shreya? Why don't you take a shot?
So yes, it is required to have your recommendation letters from teachers at school. And ideally, it's good to have one STEM and one humanities. It doesn't really, like, it's not a deal breaker if you don't have that. But I know most people tried for one STEM, one humanities. The only place that actually requires one STEM, one humanities is MIT. Other than that, it's just kind of like a thing that's like good, because it just kind of shows that you're well-rounded. And then I definitely think it's better to have a sophomore year teacher that knows you better and had you for 2 years than a junior year teacher who didn't know you as well. Because the point of your rec letter is not like, it doesn't really, like the only reason why you get a junior year teacher is just because they tend to know you better. It's not like it's the end of the world if it's a sophomore year teacher or a freshman year teacher. It's just, you just want someone that knows you well. So yeah.
Actually, is that it or any more questions?
Those were the three questions from Jessica.
So, you know, I mean, now that we brought that up, I'm just moving a little ahead on the slides. It's never too early to ask. Okay. Make sure you're asking for a recommendation. It's all about timing. If you like a teacher, the teacher likes you, ask them at least. Say, hey, would you write my recommendation? Okay. And then over the year, make sure you send them some good documentation or things that happened. And it's okay to take a teacher who was with you in sophomore year. You are better off taking that than a teacher who's, in fact, I call that like avoid celebrity hotshots who don't know you well. Just because the principal of the school is ready to give it to you, you don't want that, because you want people who can show that personal side of you that they have worked with. They're going to write some basic thing about you, that doesn't matter. Their position doesn't matter, unless you obviously are going to some, you know, clerical person in the office, but you know, it matters, okay? It's never too early to ask. Remind them of key personalized interactions. Make it part of a thank you note when you are putting it to them, saying, hey, thank you so much for doing this for me. And, you know, I just thought I'll just thank you for everything you've done for me. Here are a few things which I always remember of what you did for me. And be humble, be open. Don't, this is not a brag sheet over there. You're just telling them how they matter to you, because you're going to make them send you trust is key. Make it blind. The recommendation will go blind. Okay. If the recommendation is not blind, you might as well not take the recommendation. Blind means you'll never get to see the contents. The school teacher will send it directly to the college. So you have to make that happen. And when you send them saying, hey, can you send me a recommendation? Add your brag sheet to there. This is my brag sheet. Here's something I've written up just for you to know. details about me, stuff like that. Then treat them well, you know. Gift cards go a long way, man, in life. So big follower of that. Okay. So remember Shreya was telling you about how to email a professor. I have a template and I will send you a link to this template as well, which is, you know, things like this about, you know, what do you, you know, be very succinct and clear. And once you get this format clear, you will start sending good letters to these professors. I mean, out of 10 good professors, maybe 4 will respond. And you want to send a good letter because that letter is actually going to become a part of your application. Okay. So write very clearly, send thank you notes, proofread, say what you're asking them about, blah, blah, blah. Okay. And again, this video will be made available on my blog. So you'll get to see this. There's a link. I'll make this link available to you guys as well. The order of recommendations, as I said, college professors matter a lot. You know, reach out to the professors. We've talked in the past. I hope I've talked to you. If not, my blog will talk about it. School counselor, the guidance counselor that you have, that person matters. Internship mentor, Shreya got a letter from Jagat Ankar here at Science Gurus. And, you know, so make sure that person gives a very, that person has worked with you. They've seen you go through the hard times. They will write something different from what the school teacher write about, which is very key. This person will write something very different, your school counselor, than what the school teacher is going to write. So make sure it's balanced. Recommendations are the critical dimension. This is what easily gets ignored. And when I took that class at Stanford, they said, this is an area you definitely don't want to let get ignored. Okay, but this does get ignored. So remember that. What does a school counselor do? I wanted to read that. And you know, some schools have a guidance counselor and a school counselor. And you can see what they're here for. And you know, a school counselor will work with all the students, whereas a guidance counselor will work with only very few people, you know, so understand their roles. You know, these people facilitate therapy sessions, the guidance counselors, or anyway, but just read up again, what's, you know, you can see what guidance counselors do, what school counselors do, but they're there to work with you. A counselor will collaborate with the parents and other teachers to help you out. Use them, use that resource and, you know, get time on their calendar. I remember Shreya would send them a note like a month in advance and then they would, you know, say, okay, I'd come next month because they are busy. So make sure you know, get with on their calendars in advance. Okay. This is the traits of a solid recommendation letter. You want some of your guy has to write all these things about you, things about being honest, authentic. I get it, guys, you know. World is fairly boring. Okay, people are under a lot of stress. But if you show some of these traits, if you be yourself with people, they will remember these things about you. One of the big things about being going to college is you're learning all these things about how you can be something really cool. I mean, if I could go back to college, I would use it as a chance to really become a good person all over again. You know, change myself. I want to be trustworthy. I want to be open. I want to be myself. I want to believe in myself. I want to stay original. I want to be real. Right? I want to be an exciting person. I want to stay goddamn happy. Be the best version of who you are. This is what I want to read on a daily basis. And people should reek of this stuff in your recommendation letters. So this homework has to begin. This can't happen in the senior year, 2 days before the recommendation letter. This, you work on this as strategy. Sample letters, you know, you can see this is how the letters go out. Again, I found these things, they went out. It's like, fairly formal, but still pretty interesting. Like, you know, has good problem solving skills, over intelligence is reflected in her grades. But this is kind of what happens. Like, you know, even in the face of unwarranted attacks, she remains steadfast in her character. They will talk about things. She was caught hazing, or she got in trouble because somebody was doing something with her, but she stayed like a rock. She has integrity, right? This is the stuff that goes out. So be careful in schools, okay? The counselor is going to write these things about you. If you've done something stupid, things will go out. Invest quality time in building your brag sheet. Start early, okay? And I just walked through these earlier as well, so I don't need to go into this. Any questions on any of these areas? For recommendations, I'll take another 30 seconds.